This is a table for Simchas Torah, happiness of Torah, the joy of Torah, very, very joyful day. I mean, Jews are happy because they finished the whole cycle of the portion of the Torah, reading the Torah. Torah from God, great happiness, great joy. So it is known that this is a day which represents the future, end of days, really, which is called Yemot HaMashiach, the days of the Messiah, being the eighth day of Sukkot, number eight, represents definitely above nature. Seven is the natural number, and eight is the highest, Shmone, like the Hebrew name Neshama, the same letter, Neshama, soul, and Shmone, eight, because eight represents a higher level of the physical. So this is really what the happiness of Torah, the Simchas Torah, which we have tonight, bring lots of happiness and joy. But to get all the blessings, because it's really a time of blessings, which can have implication on the whole year. So therefore, it's amazing that you have here Messiah Smolsky here next to its peace. And the most important thing is to strengthen our faith in God. As I said many times, that in the merit of faith of God, Jews came out of Egypt, and he will come out from this exile. Now, amazing that you have here two words which are parallel, really. Blessings, bracha, and tshuva. Tshuva is repentance. Amazing. He said many times that parallel cannot be coincidence, but the most important teaching is by repentance. This is really what we should have on this day, happiness of the Torah, to repent, to return to God, and then we'll have blessing. Then we'll have Ben Ishai, the son of Jesse. Then we'll have the Messiah who will pave the way for son of Jesse. This is the Messiah, the sons of Yosef, will come for it. So, very important festival that we are going to have tonight. Tomorrow, great happiness, joy with the Torah, and lots of blessings on this day. The Messiah, son of Jesse, son of Joseph, can have peace, but all dependent, yeah? Repentance. Go back to return to the Torah. Jews have lots of commandments, but not Gentiles, non-Jews also have to keep seven. And transgressing the Torah, transgressing those seven, bring disaster to the world. We said that the flood came as a result of immorality, homosexuality, and all these things against the creation of God. God created the world to be fruitful. And if transcending it can bring lots of troubles, as we see. Our Rabbi Sela, that the whole world will not have flood of water like at that time, but flood of pestilence, of corona, will have. It's written clearly about in my YouTube, if you see, because hoping that really this happiness of the Torah, Simchas Torah, which is mainly really for Jews, because they finish the cycle of the 54, really, portions that we read through the year, and this great happiness that we have the Torah, everything is the Torah. The Torah is the blueprint of creation. But hoping the Torah, the Old Testament, all believe in, whether the Islam, whether Christianity, and the old Torah tells us that should keep this purity of life, men and women, because this is the most dangerous to the world. So hoping that the evangelists and definitely Donald Trump, they are against abortion, against the judge, are against homosexuality, because all this against the Torah. So let us hope that really this election will bring this faith, belief, there is a God, there is a Torah, and God created the world to be fruitful. And only following the verse of the Torah will have happiness, joy, all over the world.